Good morning everyone. My name is Jasmine. I am working as a assistant professor in the civil engineering department in the SMEC, that is Advanced Engineering College. Here, the fluid today I am going to discuss about the fluid mechanics. Here, there are two words are there. One is the fluid, one is the another one is the mechanics. Fluid, what is the meaning of fluid? Fluid is a substance that continuously deforms under the application of the shear stress. The substance which is continuously deforms under the application of the shear stress is known as the fluid. In this fluid, this contains these two substances. One is the liquid, and another one is the gases. Example for the liquids are water and mercury. The next one is the gases. The example for gases are here. Here the differences between the liquid and gas. The liquid is incompressible. It is difficult to compress the liquid. That is the one difference is liquid is incompressible. But gases are compressible. The next one is the liquid forms the free surface. Liquid forms the free surface when the container size is large. But the gases does not form any free surface. Gases does not form any free surface. That liquid attains the shape of the container. But it does not attain shape of container. These are the differences between the liquid and the gases. This fluid contains the two substances, one is the liquid, another one is the gases. For the liquid, the water and the mercury are the example, and for the gases, air is the example. And these are the some differences between the liquid and the gases. That is, liquid is uncompressible, but gases are compressible. We can compress the gases. Example that is LPG cylinder. This is example for the compressible gases. The next one is the liquid forms the free surface when it is contained in the container, which is having the wall. What is the largest size, and the gases does not form any free surface. The next is the liquid attains the shape of the container when it is poured in the container, but this gases does not form the shape of the container. It will spread freely. The next is the mechanics. What is the meaning of mechanics? Mechanics is the science which deals with the study of any substance in motion as well as in rest. That is, the comparatively, what is the meaning of fluid mechanics? Fluid mechanics is a branch of science which deals with the study of the fluids at rest as well as in motion. And this fluid mechanics is again divided into three groups. That is, fluid mechanics. Is divided into The next one is fluid kinetics. Fluid kinetics. The next one is fluid dynamics. Fluid dynamics. So what is the meaning of fluid statics? The fluid statics is the branch of the fluid mechanics which deals with the study of the fluid. Which deals with the study of fluid at rest is known as the fluid statics. The fluid statics is the branch of fluid mechanics which deals with the study of fluids at rest. And the, what is the meaning of fluid kinematics? Fluid kinematics is the study of fluids in motion where pressure forces are not taken into consideration for the motion of the fluid. And the next one is the fluid dynamics. Fluid dynamics is the study of fluids in motion where pressure forces are considered into taken into consideration for the movement or the body motion of the fluids. These are the three groups of the fluid mechanics. The next one is the properties of the fluids. The next topic is properties of the fluid. Properties of fluid. There are so many properties of fluids are there. One is the mass density or simply we can call it as the density, and this is represented by the symbol. The mass density is defined as the ratio of mass of the fluid to the volume of the fluid. It is defined as ratio of mass of fluid to volume of fluid. Mathematically it is written as m by v, where m is the mass of the fluid and v is the volume of the fluid. And SI unit of the mass density for the density of the fluid is kg per meter cube. This is the mass density. Next, that weight density of the fluid. The next property of the fluid is weight density of fluid. The weight density of the fluid is defined as the ratio of the weight of the fluid to its volume. And it is represented by the symbol that is W. Mathematically it is represented as that is weight of fluid to the volume of fluid. That weight of fluid is what is that? W into that is mass of fluid into acceleration due to gravity divided by volume of the fluid. That is weight density is equal to m into g divided by volume, and it is also written as that is rho into g. And this unit of the weight density of the fluid is kilonewton per meter cube. The next property of the fluid is specific volume. This is represented by V. Specific volume is the ratio of mass of the fluid to the mass density. The specific volume in the reciprocal of the mass density is represented by V is equal to volume of fluid to the mass of fluid. That is V is equal to 1 by rho, which is the reciprocal of mass density. Now SI unit of the specific volume is equal to meter cube per kg. The next property of the fluid is specific gravity. That is given by S into weight density of that weight density of the standard fluid. That is S into weight density of standard fluid for liquid means water is the standard fluid. The weight density of the standard fluid, weight density of the water is 1000 into 9.3. In case of mercury, the weight density of the standard liquid is 13.6. The next property of the fluid is viscosity. Viscosity is the property of the fluid which offers the resistance of a movement of one layer of fluid over the adjacent layer of the fluid. Okay, this is represented by that graph, that is velocity profile graph. Consider two layers of fluid which are divided distance apart and moving with the different velocity u and the u plus delta u. This viscosity together with relative velocity give the shear stress. This shear stress is directly proportional to the rate of the shear strain. That is, the shear stress is represented by the tau. This is directly proportional to the rate. du by dy. And this shear stress is given by tau is equal to u into du by dy, where u is like constant of proportionality. Constant of proportionality, and it is also known as the dynamic viscosity. And this dynamic viscosity is represented by the formula tau mu is equal to tau divided by du by dy. That is, dynamic viscosity is defined as the rate of shear stress required to produce the required shear strain. The next is the and the SI unit of this dynamic viscosity is Newton second per meter square. The next is kinetic viscosity. Is represented by the symbol that is mu. Kinematic viscosity is defined as the ratio of the dynamic viscosity to the density of the fluid. That is, mu is equal to dynamic viscosity to the density of the fluid. And the SI unit of that kinematic viscosity is meter square per second. Next, Newton's law of viscosity. The next is the Newton's law of viscosity. Newton's law of viscosity states that the shear stress is directly proportional to the shear strain for the real fluids. That is, here mathematically represented by shear stress is directly proportional to the shear strain, that is, dynamic velocity gradient, and this is already I discussed it previously, that is, tau is equal to mu into divided by s. The mu is the dynamic viscosity and the du by dy is the velocity gradient or the shear deformation. Next, the variation of the viscosity is tensile.